So I hope you had some success with your decision tree in scikit-learn. Now let me show you the decision tree decision boundary that I got when I tried this problem. So here's what I got, and you can immediately see that the decision tree decision boundary is very distinctive. You get all these jagged little lines. It almost looks like, you know, a piece of modern art or something, where it's carving out all these horizontal and vertical cuts that it makes because of the structure of the decision tree, where it's running around trying to slice the boundary in such a way that it can get as many points as it can in the training set. You can see that it can also have little islands, just like the SVM did. And in general, this is the shape that's going to characterize a decision tree or decision tree boundary. One of the things you might be noticing is that there's some signs of overfitting, perhaps, in this decision tree. That we have these long slices, like this one here and this one here, where the decision tree seems to be kind of going out of its way in an unnatural way. And I bet that if you plotted the training points instead of the test points on top of this decision boundary, you'd find that there's a few blue training points that are maybe out along here that are causing the decision boundary to come way out and try to pick those up. And likewise for maybe some red points over here.